Thanks. Wisconsin saw its highest voter turnout in 60 years for a presidential year partisan primary. More than 26% of the state's voting age population cast ballots in Tuesday's election. The election was also the first under newly drawn legislative maps, leading to dozens of competitive races. In Your Voice, Your Vote coverage, Emily Riley spoke with Green Bay City Clerk, who discussed some of the challenges experienced at local polling locations.
In Green Bay, voter turnout was strong. City Clerk Celestine Jeffries described it as one of the busiest elections in recent memory.
In terms of what I hear from the chief inspectors at locations, and then just the number of ballots that were being requested, which was a lot.
She highlighted some of the challenges voters faced, specifically the complexity of the partisan primary, which requires voters to stay within party lines on a double-sided ballot. She says some voters accidentally cast more votes in a contest than are allowed, also known as overvoting. Jeffrey says some polling locations also had long lines because they ran out of printed ballots.
So we have some fairly heavy registration districts on the far east side and the far west side, but it wasn't only those places. It was places all over the city.
Some noteworthy outcomes from the election. Businessman Tony Weed won the GOP primary against Senator Andre Jacques and Roger Roth for the 8th congressional district. He outlined what he plans to do moving forward.
And I'm going to go to Washington and actually solve problems and take a pragmatic approach and truly do what's right for the people of District 8.
Meanwhile, Dr. Kristen Lierley has been declared the Democratic nominee for the 8th congressional district after running unopposed. She also highlighted her campaign plans.
That's the thing that I'm excited about, and that's what we're hearing as we're knocking on doors, as we're making phone calls, as we're talking with people in Northeast Wisconsin. They're ready for change, and that's what we're bringing.
Now looking ahead toward the November election, Jeffries wants to remind voters it's not too early to make sure you have everything you need ready to go for Election Day. Reporting in Green Bay, Emily Riley, Action 2 News.